Good morning, good morning, kings and queens. This is Beyond the Walls Ministry, and I'm your minister, TJ Beattie. This morning, our scripture will be coming from John chapter 15, verse 13. And it reads, "Greater love hath no one than this, to lay down one's life for one's friend." This morning, I just want to talk about his love is the greatest of them all. See, in this world, we'll come across many people. We'll come across many relationships, whether it's male or female, whether it's family members. We'll experience many, many relationships. And a lot of people will tell you that they love you. And you know, when people tell you that they love you, that means that there's a certain sincerity they have for you in their heart. It means that they'll go all out. They'll go beyond what's the norm. Their expectations will exceed what others is when they use that word love. When they say that they love you. When they say that that you are truly a person that they love. You know, love has actions behind it. There's an expression that takes place when someone tells you that they love. But in this scripture right here, it says, "Greater love has no one than this, to lay down one life." You know, you think that when you've been in a relationship with someone for so long, or you think that when you know people and you've been in their life for so long, you tend to say, "Hey, I'll die for you. I'll lay down my life for you. I'll give it all for you." But it's easy just to say that. But when that situation is actually before you, when you're put in that moment, when you're in the fire, how do you respond? How do you react at that moment? Do you really show that form of love? Does it really happen then? Because it's easy to say it. But until you are actually immersed in that situation is when we truly know who you are. When you say that you are a believer of Christ, when you say that you are a man or woman that loves God and loves him, what happens when you get in the fire? How do you really trust him like you say that you really trust him? When somebody puts you in a situation and your life even may be at risk, do you still stand on the word and say that, "Hey, I love God, I'll die for God. I believe in his word no matter what you say or do to me. I know that God's word is true, it's real." But you have to know that the most gracious, the most mightiful, the most powerful, the most all-knowing, the one who is the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords. You have to know that, guess what? He loves you. He loves you so much that he actually went to the cross for you and I. He actually laid down his life for you and I because he wanted you and I to experience more than just what's in this world. He wanted you to experience what's in the world to come. He wanted you to have more than just the blessings here. He wanted you to have the blessings being with his Father, the blessing of being in the presence of his Father. He wanted you to have all these things. So guess what he did? He wanted to make sure that the relationship with him and you could never be torn, could never be broken, that it would be everlasting. So he came into this world. He came down 42 generations into this world. He came here. He was the ultimate example, walked this earth, taught the word of God. He lived it. He healed. He delivered. He blessed. He did all those things just to show you that he's real. That he's real about what he says and about what he does, that he'll never lie to you. And so he laid down his life. He died for you and I. See, it's easy for us to say that. But will you lay down your life for Christ? Will you lay down your life for your brothers and sisters of Christ? Will you do that on today? Are you that committed? Do you have that type of endurance in you for man and woman? Because Jesus Christ did it. He came into this world and he died. But he just didn't die. He rose the third day with all power in his hand. He rose with all power in his hand to show you and I, to show the world that he is the one. That he is the savior of the world. That he is the redeemer. He is the one who has all strength, all power in his hand. That he can do anything but fail. We just have to trust him. We have to believe. We have to know that he is our savior. Every day that you wake up, he gives you another opportunity. Every time that you don't have, he opens doors for you. Every time that you get sick, he heals you. Every time that you put yourself in a situation where you might even get in trouble with the law, he opens doors for you. He's always making a way for you and I. His love is that powerful. God wants us to operate in his love because he knows that when we operate in his love, that we treat people right. that we live a righteous life, that we make good decisions based on, guess what, the heart that we have that's aligned with Christ. So I'm saying, there may be somebody out there on today, they may be walking in this world. They may have not, they not be in understanding or know the realness of God, understanding that the power of love that he has for you and I. Well, you can have that love on today. His love is so powerful that it restores relationships that have been broken for years. It mends situations that have been broken for years. It fixes situations that have been broken for years. It gives comfort to every situation. His love heals in places that you and I could only imagine. His love. So if that's you on today and you need his love on today, one of the first things that you need to do is you need to submit on today. You need to say this prayer with me. Say, dear God, you are my father and I'm your child. I believe that Jesus Christ died, but he rose with the third day with all power in his hand. And if you believe that, I believe on today that you are saved. If you said that and believe and have courtesy in your heart, you are saved on today. And that love that you've been wanting, that you've been needing, will be in your heart. It will be in your atmosphere all the time. Not just some of the time, but all the time. And there may be somebody that needs prayer on today. They may be dealing with a situation. They may have a broken heart, broken mind. They just need mending on today. So allow me to pray with you on today. Most gracious eternal Father, God, we come today for those that are broken on today, that are torn, that are lost, that need your guidance, that need your protection, that need your strength, that need your help, God, on today, God. They may be lost, God. We need you to send your angels, God. Touch them where they are, heal them where they are, strengthen them where they are, deliver them where they are, so that they may come back to you on today, God. So the relationship with you and them will be healed, it will be restored, it will be repaired on today, God. In the mighty name of Jesus, God. And there are those others that need to understand your love, that they need love in their heart. Maybe they've been living in hate. They may be living in sin. God, we say that your love is so powerful, God, that when you touch them, they will experience your newness, your fullness, your wholeness, God. And they will be able to walk brand new. I believe that it is happening right now. In the mighty name of Jesus, we pray and we thank you and we love you. Amen. Hey guys, we thank you again for tuning in with Beyond the Walls Ministry. Be blessed. Hey! If you did it before.